Hello everyone, this is Skinner from Liquipedia, and I'm here to show you how to make a player page on Liquipedia. Now, to make sure, there's two other tutorials out there to get started with maybe. One's just how to create a page and how to edit, and the other one about the notability guidelines. So that one involves more like, when do you create a page? Make sure to check on that wiki if your page can actually be made or if it's not within the guidelines. Basically, this is a very broad tutorial that sort of tries to cover all of our wikis. Every wiki will have its own special things for player pages on their wiki. For example, some might have a list of heroes that a player is good at, or they have a special thing to show their recent stats in certain tournaments or recent matches. So this version covers the most basic parts about a player page. Per wiki it might be different, so people might add things onto your page or change things depending on how they're done there. So that's just a general disclaimer. So to get started, we have a thing called the page catalog, which sort of gives you an easy copy paste that should be generally universal across the wikis to give you a start. So let's first go over how a player page generally looks. So generally a player page, I can pull one up here as well. We can build up zero in Apex Legends. On the right, there's an info box, which goes over some basic general information. There's an image, the real name of the player, date of birth, when they were active, alternate IDs, team list, history of the teams, and there will be a general blurb that explains just a sentence who the player is, and if they have a biography, there might be more text, it might be further down the page, it depends on the wiki. And then some wikis will list gear and information about the player, like what sort of sensitivities they run, or which mouse buttons they have bound, which gear they use. Then there's a short overview of some achievements, and then there's a results subpage, which will list all of their results. Sometimes there's some charts or a list of awards. This one has a full biography. There's a media list with articles and highlights on this player, and there's a gallery. So if we go to our catalog, you'll see the same explained here. The right is an info box, there's an achievement section, and this is sort of the code that makes most of this stuff happen. So in this article, you can find a more in-depth description about all of the things that are listed in the code, but I'll just go over it through the tutorial. So what we'll do is I'll select and copy all of the basic stuff here and go to my user page and create the page here. Might take a bit to load. So we're on the page and I can copy paste the thing. You can either like drag all over it or just use the select and copy button and it will automatically copy paste it into your system. So let's start off. So this here sets the tabs at the top of the page. So overview, results. On wikis that have more like matches, it will automatically appear. This is a template, a universal across wikis, and then we start off. So the ID is the gamer tag of the player that they will generally use. Don't include any like team tags or Twitch TV or FPS or whatever, just the clean name they would use across social. So let's just call him Player 2, very inspiring name. Then there's IDs. So sometimes players change tags they use throughout their career. Maybe he was once known as Player 1, 2, 3. You can list this here. Then there's the image. You can pull up an image through comments. I recommend checking the uploading an image tutorial first for this one. But you can put a file name here and it will show the image in the info box. Then we get to the name. What can be confusing is there's name, romanized name, family name, given name. So for names for countries where they don't use the Latin script, so let's say for example in Russia they use Cyrillic, or in Greece they have the Greek alphabet, you would generally first input the name here in that script, and then a romanized name is how the name looks like if it was translated to Latin. If the name is from a player that just lives in a country where they use a Latin script, you can just use that instead. So you can remove this for this case, for example, keeping it easy. Now let's just call this man Joe Johnson as a starter. Then here, family given name. For this case, you can give a name to Joe, last name or family name is Johnson. This is mostly important because the introduction line is automatically generated, and some countries flip whether the last name or family name is first. For example, in Asia, this is very common. So this automatically will sort of flag this to our system, like, hey, these are the names you have to pay attention to. Then the birthday, it's in year, month, day format. So let's say 1990, October 1st. So that's the date of birth entered. Then we go to country. You can either use a two-letter code, but I just recommend writing a full country name. So in this case, let's go with Greece. Then there's a role. Sometimes this can be a role that they have in a game, like AD carry, mid lane, if it's a MOBA. or IGL, author, rifler, if you have something like CSGO, but it can also mean coach or manager. So if it's a player, you can generally ignore this. Status, there's usually a couple types. Usually it's active. If it's just a current player that active as a career, you can put inactive here if the player is on a break that they've actually announced, like, hey, I'm stepping away for a while, but I'm not fully gone. If they've said that, hey, I'm quitting, you can put retired. And then in case the player has been banned in the past, you can put banned. But let's just assume that player is currently still active. Team. Sometimes the team input is automated based on the transfers that you can enter totally somewhere else. And it appears automatically. Sometimes it doesn't. Some wikis don't use it. It's very different. But let's say in this case, this player plays for Team Liquid. We just make sure it shows here. Then there is URL section. There's a lot more options available here in terms of what it supports. Different games also have specific platforms to them, but generally the rule is you don't write out the full URL. You just use anything that comes after the slash. So let's say player two has Instagram or Twitch account with an underscore, you just put player two underscore. You basically only use that. You don't use the full URL. YouTube can be something different. Player two, one, two, I don't know. It just automatically generates something. So then player introduction, this will, maybe not my user space, this will automatically write, for example, in Zero's case, it's ReZero Perryborn, yada yada, is an Australian player who's currently playing for Team Falcons. It basically creates this sentence automatically based on the things that are inputted in the info box. Then the achievements, sometimes you will just need to enter the player name here in this, but it will usually also take the name of the page as a default, but we can input player 2. I don't know if player 2 is a player here, so we will just currently steal an achievement one, so you can actually see how the achievements are supposed to look. Same for here. Awards. The gallery, as shown here, what you can do is you, same here, you type the image file name here, and then you can give a general description. So what's happening on this page, for example, down here, you can see a written text like Zero at the 2024 Esports World Cup with Team Falcons, and some links to the events. So we could write this here as well. The media list, this creates this list based on any articles that have been inputted into the system. So you can ignore this for now, but you can sometimes for Ricky, people leave it up there just in case things have been added, it can list them. So for example, if I would input Zero here, we'll grab his list and I can give an example. And then once you're done, we can check show preview, which will give us a small preview of how the page might look like, just in case we might have broken something. Sometimes, for example, if you accidentally remove one of the squiggly brackets, it breaks the template and it might look broken, so then you can double check if nothing's actually broken before you put it live. But this is generally how I'm expecting things to look like. You have your information that we've inputted here on the right. It automatically calculates the age, and then we can just let, this looks good. We hit save, and we have just created a player page. If you are not a full contributor yet, your page will first need to be checked. If there's anything wrong with it, people might just come in, fix you, and help you. If the page is not notable, it might get moved to your user space. Don't be afraid that it's deleted. It might just be in a different place. Again, you can read more on the notability guidelines or watch the tutorial video on this. But yeah, everything here looks as it's supposed to be. You can see the media listed that would be under the name Zero. We've gotten the achievements from a different player. You can have the social links, as you mentioned. You get icons here that will link you out to the socials. And that's just generally how the page will look like. Obviously, I recommend checking every wiki if there's any specialties that you might want to add. Some wikis have different templates. But generally, this should work across all wikis. And it's a good basic stepping stone. And that's about it. I recommend just having some fun with it, trying things, see how things change. Sometimes I recommend, hey, just try and edit one small thing that you think like, okay, what happens if I change this to Netherlands? And then you can sort of visually see, hey, it's actually changing these things. So yeah, I hope this was helpful to you. If you wanted to create any player pages, and if you have any questions, feel free to reach out in Discord. Anyone was generally trying to help you if you ask your questions there.